button and ask you if you want to, So if you see this, don't be alarmed. We're just going to be recording our session. Anyway, welcome everybody. Again, wanted to wish everybody a happy 73rd birthday to Israel. And the word Sion, the word Zion in Hebrew, is related, the same word Hebrew, for excellence. And this is an incredible message to us as Jews, that the Jewish homeland is referred to as Zion, because as Jews, as humans, really our goal is always to strive towards excellence in everything we do. And that means that our journey is never complete. And so too, the state of Israel is always growing, is always striving to be even better. And an incredible moment in history right now with Israel leading the world in the vaccine rollout. Some history which you might already know about is that the CEO of Pfizer, Albert Bourla, is actually himself the son of Greek survivors of the Holocaust. And he prioritized the vaccination of Holocaust survivors on Yom HaShoah in tribute to what his parents went through, the incredible, awful experiences his parents went through in Thessalonica in Greece. And it was a community in Greece of 50,000 Jews, of which only 2,000 remain. So that's 96% decimation rate, which is awful to think about. But in interviews, Albert Bourla says his family is always oriented towards celebration and towards living life. And that, in that spirit, he prioritized Israel also in receiving the Pfizer vaccine. And so he was expressing how proud he is of the Israeli state. And again, tonight is all about celebrating life, celebrating the fact that we're here, we're healthy, we have a Jewish homeland, that one of the oldest people in the world, one of the most persecuted people in the world, always has a safe haven. Every Jew, all of us have a homeland. And so we celebrate that tonight. So I wanna say l'chaim to the state of Israel. And I wanna welcome again, Ariel, his band, the Kahol, are gonna be performing for us. Further ado, again, I wanna welcome, everyone can do a virtual round of applause, welcoming, giving a big Bethel welcome to cantor Ariel Wyner and the Kahol. I'm gonna remove spotlight and we'll dive in.
All right, we're gonna go right into it.
Yachad lev el lev yiftach v'meniyeh tahor sheba shamayim yachad lev el lev yiftach v'tikvah Le'ahava, ech she'alev niftach, zavek et ha'olam, uvekriya gdola, lashir li ahava, kimru hakol lev shar, oze lo meucha. Hashachar kvar ala, ze zman le'ahava. Yachad lev el lev niftach v'nireh tahor sheba shamayim. Yachad lev el lev niftach v'tikvah. Derech
Chag Sameach. It is so, so good to be with you once more, still virtually, Temple Beth El Yardley. One of these days, I'll actually be with you all in person, but for now, here we are, and we're very, very, very happy to be playing with you on such a joyous occasion. And thank you, Rabbi Reish, for bringing us on and for those really, really amazing words to get us into the spirit. So that was Shir Le'Ahava. That was one of my favorite songs that I grew up learning at Camp Ramah in the Poconos. And we always used to sing that one in Shira. That was like the staple Israeli song that almost for a matter of fact that everyone would like no matter what. So I still love that song today, and I brought it to these guys, and they really enjoyed it as well. So we're next going to transition into one of our own original songs. This one's called Esa Enai. It's from Psalm 129, and Sophie and I wrote this one together. And without further ado, let's play it.
Hashem Oseh Shamayim Baharetz Ezri Meim Hashem Oseh Shamayim Shamayim Baharetz Zai, 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 sing with us! Zai, 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 come on! Zai, 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 time on the, without the lyrics.
Thank you. We had, I hope that you had as much of a blast singing along with us as we had singing with each other. It's really been powerful to continue to write Nigunim during this time when we haven't been able to be with each other. But I can imagine, as we're singing these songs and this Nigun in this space right now, I really can imagine actually being present with you and hearing all of your voices and sharing that. We're going to transition to another song that we've done. What we kind of get started with when we were first meeting, what was it, last year? We were first meeting right when we formed, and then the pandemic hit like 3 weeks later. So we haven't really been able to play out so much. This is our form of playing out with this band. But right at the start of that, we put together a series of four songs that were all related to Kabbalat Shabbat. And we wanted to put our Jewish twist on bluegrass and combining the two, and we sort of found a voice through that with some of these songs. So here is Ana Bekoach, which is found in the Kabbalat Shabbat service in the liturgy, and Sophia Chiarandini. I get to introduce Sophia now. Sophia is going to sing for us, and she's been playing fiddle tonight, and she'll be singing a few more for us. So give it up for Sophia Chiarandini.
Thank you.
Shall we? So Corey picks this one off.
Thank you.
That was Sophia Chirandini. Wow. I forgot to mention this. So the way that this connects to bluegrass, I didn't even tell you. So this connects to bluegrass because this is the same melody as Bury Me Beneath the Willow, which is a very popular song and one of the first songs that I got into when I was listening to bluegrass. I think you showed me an amazing version of that song that I've stuck with me since. And that led us to doing it here. So I really like that song. We're next going to shift to a bunch of Israeli songs. I know it's Yom Ha'atzmaut, so we promise Israeli songs. This is one of my favorites. These are all my favorites. Every one of them are my favorites. That's why I picked them. I keep on saying it, they're my favorites. This is Matanot Tanot. I learned this one at Camp Ramon, the Poconos. It was our Friday night dance. That's interesting. What does that mean? Before Shabbat, we would do a Friday night dance and a song when it was your Shabbat. And if, for those who went to Ramah Poconos or Ramah, I know a bunch of you have connections there. You know what I'm talking about. So I think it was my Bogrim dance was Matanot Tanot. And this song has stuck with me forever. And I, just recently, I decided to actually learn it on the musical instrument and bring it to this band. So here's Matanot Tanot. And before we start, I want to make one more introduction. This is Corey Brodsky on the guitar. Give it up for Corey Brodsky. Yeah. Yeah. And he's going to start this one off for us.
האור והצל משחקים שוב תופסת השולחן ערוך תמונות ילדות על הקיר שערות לבנות חוזרות מבית כנסת והריח הזה ששורט לי את הלב מתגנב ופותח את רטון נושל קטן אלו שושיר ישן שעובר אצלנו במשך דורו מתנות קטנות שהוא שלח לי מתנות קטנות בסיסים של כוונה עיקולים של אמונה מתנות קטנות מי שהוא שלח לי מתנות קטנות כמו הכוח לקבל ומה שאין ומה שיש מה עוד אפשר כבר לבקש זה עוד יום שישי מרפסת בעיתון השמש כמו הדאגות לאט נמחקת מנגינות פשוטות זוכלות מהחלון בשום שערה כבר לא תסתיר פה את השקט מתנות קטנות מי שהוא שלח לי מתנות קטנות רסיסים של כוונה רסיסים של אמונה מתנות קטנות מי שהוא שלח לי מתנות קטנות כמו הכוח לקבל עם מה שאין עם מה שיש מה עוד אפשר כבר לבקר ואותנו קידשת ברוך אתה עד השם מקדש השבת והריח הזה ששורט לי את הלב מתגנב מתגנב ופותח דלתות אל אושר קטן אל אותו שיר ישן שעובר אצלנו במשך דורו מתנות קטנות מי שהוא שלח לי מתנות קטנות רסיסים של כוונה רסיסים של אמונה מתנות קטנות מי שהוא שלח לי מתנות קטנות כוח לקבל עם מה שאין עם מה שיש
Thank you. For for this next matanot ktanot means tiny gifts. And tomorrow is Shabbat, and it's referring to tomorrow. Shabbat, we welcome in Shabbat as a tiny gift. Because it is. And it happens every week. But it also is a big gift.
It's a large gift.
It's yeah. a large gift.
It's a frequent big gift.
A frequent big gift. I wonder why it was called matanot ktanot then. That's funny. It's poetry. So okay. Let's do. I'm gonna introduce G Rockwell right now. Sorry, I gotta get out of that mood into like you're playing. So G's gonna play one of my another. I'm not gonna say it this time. This is one of my rather fond songs that I have, called. What's it called? Hallelujah Leolam. And this was the 1979 Eurovision winner. And I really like the song, so let's do it. And I'm starting. Sorry, I gotta get back in.
Yashir kulam Bemiyachat Bodidach Bemilmon todah Beolem gamor zeh Olam niflah Alleluia Im ashir Alleluia Al yom shemeir Alleluia Al ma sheaya U ma sheod lo haya Alleluia
One song that I'm gonna play guitar on, and now's the time. So Corey and I are gonna do a little bit of a choreography change right now.
Yalla!
Not yet, right?
Is it not yet?
It is now.
Yeah, no.
No.
Oh, it's next. No, it's next. Just kidding. Sorry, I skipped right over it. This next one, I know for sure all of you will know. This one's Yerushalayim Shel Zahav, and we're just gonna get right into it.
Avir harim salukayahin vereach oranim misa beruach harbaim im kol pamonim uvetar demat ilan vaeven shuya vachaloma asher bada yoshevet Yerushalayim shel zahav ve shel nechoshet ve shel or hanolechu
This is their Israeli Independence Day performance by some klezmer band.
This is the thing with Bethel?
Yeah.
Sophia Carandini for doing such a lovely job. My favorite.
That's one of my favorite songs too. I have to stop saying that. They're all amazing. All
right. That's okay. Favorite does it. Love multiplies.
I'm so happy to be playing this music. All right, Corey, let's do a little switch.
Yeah, let's do it. Some Corey.
At this point, I want to give a huge, huge thank you to Owen Meadows, who's doing our sound for tonight. So give it up for Owen Meadows. He's doing such a great job. He's taking care of the mics, the balancing, the cameras, and the Zoom. He's doing so great.
He's in the pilot seat.
And don't worry, Austin. I'll thank you later. We have a special guest in the audience who's cheering us on. next song brings me back to when I studied abroad in Israel a few years ago. This was the one song that I didn't know, that I wasn't taught at Camp Hermon the Poconos, of all the songs that we're singing tonight. This one, it's by Alon Eder, who's really, really big in Israel. This song's called Shir Li Ima. Let's do it. To gagurim sheshomrim otach iti mehazman hametashter mehaderech hameyesh im uchali otatzuv lerega gam meyesameyach kol hagalim מתקרבים אך נשפרים חלומות ללא מילים ופנייך אינם פרועים פה בחוף הנפתחים אפשר כמעט ולהגיע אתה לא לבד תראה that I have not yet had the honor of introducing, and that is Noah Harrington on bass. Give it up for Noah Harrington.
Yeah, it's me.
And I haven't told you this yet, but you're going to take a break on this next one.
On this next one? On the Israel medley?
On the Israel medley. So we're going to do a fun Israel medley. Two classic Israel medleys that you all know and love. Please sing along. That's the point. We're going to start off with Artsa Alinu, and then we're going to go into Am Yisrael Chai.
Oh, okay. I thought it was,
No, just like you're going to play something.
I misunderstood. My bad.
No,
I had rehearsed these songs. I thought he was telling me that I wasn't playing on them. That's on me. I was like, okay, I guess I'll go.
No.
Cool.
No.
Taking a different kind of break than I thought.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
No,
okay.
That's on me.
So I'll explain that. So in the bluegrass world, when someone takes a break on something, it means they're going to play. exactly.
Completely the opposite of taking a break.
And what Noah thought was, oh, it's time for me to take a break. See ya.
I was confused.
I understand. Let's go into this one.
One, two, three, four.
Sing with us. Oh, Navinu, Navinu, Navinu.
happens when the lending goes the way you want it. Okay, thank you so much. Our time is nearing an end. We're so, so happy to be here. Thank you once again to Rabbi Reish. And our final thank you of the night goes to Austin. We have a special guest, Austin, who's been watching. He's been smiling. He's been egging us on. And it really makes a huge difference to us, having at least one person really engaged in the room. We know that you're all here listening and watching, and we're so appreciative to each and every one of you who has taken the time out of your night to come enjoy Yom Ha'atzmaut with us.
And we can't wait to be in person with all of you again.
Yes, it's right around the corner. It so feels that way. And we'll take this joy and simcha and bring it into the time that we see each other. We're going to end with a classic that we play called Lecha Dodi. You might have heard of it. It's from the Friday Night Liturgy. And we're going to do this to a bluegrass tune called The Old Home Place. Thank you so much for an amazing, amazing, amazing celebration. And thank you, Rabbi Reish, for having us. You're so good.
Thank you so much, Kol Kahol. Can we all give, actually, we're going to unmute everybody so everyone can give it up for Kol Kahol. What an incredible performance. Everybody,
Mazel Tov, amazing.
Oh. Yeah.
You're the best.
I'm here, guys.
And just a few announcements before we wrap. I want to first of all thank so much the amazing members of Kol Kahol. I want to thank Cantor Ariel, and I want to say a Mazel Tov to Cantor Ariel, because as some of you know, he got engaged a few months ago to the amazing Sophia, who's next to him, amazing fiddler and singer, and to their musician colleagues, friends, to G and to Noah and to Corey. and to their mechanic engineer Owen.
Corey, would that be Corey Brodsky?
Yeah. Such a wonderful. And G, yes. And actually, if we could just mute all for a second, I wanted to say a few couple of closing thank yous. I want to thank so much everyone who made tonight possible. Again, our board of trustees, our board of directors, our amazing office manager, Barbara Schwartz, and a huge thank you to Steve and Debbie Lipschitz, who helped with the amazing Judah Grill food this afternoon, and to all the folks who made this possible. I also want to give a quick plug to some upcoming events. We have some amazing things happening down the pike. This Sunday, we kick off at 4 p.m. Wandering Jews series, where we get to meet with different communities across the country and across the world to learn contemporary topics of the day. We're talking about Israel, democracy, and monarchy with Oklahoma City, a conservative shul there with a wonderful colleague there, Abby Jacobson, and her shul at Emmanuel Synagogue this Sunday at 4. And I also want to give a plug. We have an ongoing food insecurity awareness social action committee. This month we have a canned protein drive. We've enjoyed so much amazing food at tonight at this celebration. We can thank God for this wonderful repast by, you know, paying it forward. So you can look at our website for more information to contribute. You can do it directly on Amazon. We have a direct link. And we have a SNAP challenge event connected with that. And especially Shabbat, April 24th, special food insecurity Shabbat. So please join us for all those events. And many folks have been asking me if tonight was recorded. Yes, it was recorded, and it's going to be uploaded to the Beth L YouTube sometime this week. So if you want to relive this incredible concert, please, please check it out. And again, want to wish everyone a wonderful Yom Ha'atzmaut, Yom Ha'atzmaut Sameach, and happy 73rd birthday to Israel. What an incredible way to celebrate. Want to thank again Kol Kahol for this incredible performance. And you can check them out, Kol Kahol, and Cantor Ariel has another band called the Rutabagers with an R at the end, which you can also check out online. They're amazing. So again, give it up for Kol Kahol, everybody. All right, everyone stay safe, stay healthy. And in 2 minutes, you can join us for Minyan on the same link, evening services. So you can come back, stay on. Be happy to daven with you.
Hi, Sadie.
All right.
Hey. Hi, everybody.
Hi, hello to my parents. Thanks,
and hello to my Sadie.
And your bubby. All right, thanks, everybody.
Hi, Rabbi. Welcome back.